The following is a presentation of the HAN Network, the leader for local news, sports, and entertainment in Fairfield and Westchester counties.
And good afternoon, everyone. Welcome to Stamford High School, just outside of Boyle Stadium. With Raquel Welsh, I'm Rob Adams. AJ Simonowski, along with us, as well as Eric Gendron directing. We're going to watch the Greenwich Cardinals take on the Stamford Black Knights. And Raquel, no time like the present to get it underway. So off we go with the Black Knights in white and the Cardinals in the road red, or the road cardinal, if you will. It's on the near side. Coming down into that corner, and we get our first whistle of the day to get us started. Off the throw in, and the Black Knights trying to reset. Now I'm gonna let Raquel handle all of the pronunciations.
We'll see how that goes.
She went over and spoke with head coach Mario Caminiti of the Black Knights. So she got all the pronunciations before the broadcast.
I tried to write them out phonetically.
Yes,
we'll
she
see
did.
If that works.
You actually did a very good job. So 52 seconds gone by, and the Black Knights moving from right to left. Off the long goalie kick, comes into the Cardinal end. Played over by on the near side by the Cardinals. That was Zach Freeman, the junior. Near side here, Andy Lewis for the Black Knights. He boats it across. Over to Jerry Filigene it goes. That was Patrick Tomaszak. And down into the left corner. Now, this is one of those more unforgiving kind of fields in that you don't have a lot of room. Once you get back behind the net, there's not much there. You're going to a fence.
Right. It's a lot of runoff down into the field. You can't see it either.
Just underway. No score. A minute and change gone by. A decent crowd on hand. Bill Bloxham, Marty Hersom, Josh Fisher, Tracy Iazzi, among the rest of our crew. We're trying to make Raquel nice and comfortable here.
It's been great. It's been easy, smooth sailing. I just had to get names.
This is the toughest part now, right?
Right.
Off the throw in, the Black Knights have it bounce off the head of Filigene into the Cardinal zone it goes, but the Cardinals able to clear it out. Kevin Aguadello, the junior, sent ahead to Philip Peck, midfielder for the Black Knights. 3-4-1 coming into this one. As they'll go over to the Cardinal bench. So no score. Just about 3 minutes gone by. Any feeling for the flow? I mean, we're only 3 minutes in, but what are you sensing early on?
Well, just based off of warm-ups, watching Greenwich, they're pretty much in a good attacking position and seem they really want to drive up with the ball, and Stamford's really having to play on their toes defensively.
Black Knights were trying to play it on the far side. It'll get turned back the other way. Jose Romero, the outstanding goalie, the keeper in net for Greenwich. And Michael Ortiz down to our right for the Black Knights. As it comes over to the near side and returned into the Cardinal end. Inakay Mendive playing it there for Greenwich. He'll reset and go across. And the left footer for the Cardinals sends it down into the Black Knights side of the field. Just about 4 minutes gone by, first half. Technically, I suppose you could call it Boyle Stadium. This doesn't actually have a name to it. But Boyle Stadium itself down to our far right. That, of course, the longtime home of the FCAC football championship, among many others. The Black Knight football team has played there forever. Alejandro McLean for the Cardinals goes down into the right corner, put on net, the lift, and they score.
Wow.
So the Cardinals get the first goal. It comes in the fifth minute, and it's 1-0. What'd you see for Greenwich that made that play come together?
They really pressure the ball. They're not letting Stamford have more than one or two touches without going after it. Going right in and attacking from the corner, it's a good angle for them to get a shot on goal because the goalie can't really see from that side of the net.
1-0, Big Red as they like to be called. Certainly the football team is always known as Big Red, but all the Cardinal teams really go by that name. As it bounces over to the near side, played by the Black Knights and Andy Lewis. Now returned to the left by Zach Friedman. You can spy Nick Bartles, who I know you and I were exchanging emails about. He's wearing number 3 in the red jersey, the red kit, down to our right. He's right out near the midfield stripe as it goes on net at the other end and grabbed by Romero. 1-0 Greenwich. Go ahead.
Yeah, he led the leading scorer last year in goals for Boys FCX. He had a really good season. They were interviewing him, talking about he just was in the New England Sports Journal for soccer about his upcoming season and being recruited this year.
And we saw him early on when they took on the Wilton Warriors. He himself had an outstanding game. 1-0 our score as we watch it again. For me, one thing I have to get used to is having a monitor set up alongside of me, thanks to Eric Gendron today.
Nice
to have it.
It's an up-close view to watch.
I know. Bill Bloxham working that camera down to our right as it gets returned deep into the Black Knight zone. We're in the seventh minute, and we have a 1-0 Greenwich lead. All the way out it comes from goalie kick to the far side. Greenwich has Kevin Romero over there, a senior, along with Nico Ortiz. Now the Black Knights looking to get something going. Slowing things up and grabbing it was Victor Garage. Just let me know if I'm saying them wrong.
I have to look at my phonetic notes.
That was that one.
I think that's right.
Okay. Still 1-0 Greenwich.
Get a call in for the mispronunciation of the name.
It wouldn't be the first time. You know, and we say that often, and you know, you've been around high school athletics a long time yourself, that there is no SID. There's no sports info director that's able to say, oh, no, wait, I've got all the notes and pronunciations for it. No, that doesn't exist at this level.
Right.
So we always say, you know, just a gentle tap on the shoulder and say it's pronounced Adams, not Adams, and you're all set. And no, that's really not how you pronounce it. Off to the far side, although you'd be surprised. People can't even screw up my last name.
Adams.
7 and change gone. First half, 1-0. Greenwich on top. We'll get the bookkeeping taken care of a little bit later on. We saw about 45 minutes, as A.J. Simonowski and I were talking about yesterday, of really good field hockey. And then it all kind of fell apart. But Ridgefield and Darien played themselves a terrific game up at Tiger Hollow until the Blue Wave scored their first goal. And the Blue Wave are so good, you kind of felt like it was game over right there.
They're a phenomenal team.
Yeah, oh, they're just terrific. On the near side was Ortiz for Greenwich.
Now Greenwich just really has good composure. Just the ball, not feeling pressured.
And I'll take it back out on the near side. Edward Quiroga throws back in. Goes to Ortiz. Down the right side for Alejandro McLean. And the Black Knights will let it roll down to Michael Ortiz. Greenwich leads 1-0. As we're coming up on 8.5 gone by in the first half. Of course, this is a much newer field of any type. They've been playing football and had graduation as far back as 1937 at Boyle Stadium. Almost a good chance for the Black Knights, but nothing cooking there. So we stay up at 1-0. That was Leal Valladares. You did do a good job. I knew what to say.
trying to read it out loud. You just have to practice it.
Mario Caminiti was so much fun to talk to. Just a wealth of information. Kirk Putnam, of course, the longtime coach at Greenwich as well. And he was laughing, Coach Caminiti, about the relationship the two of them have for many years and longtime friends that they are. Coming down and close to the 10-minute mark gone by in the first half. There's Bartles in the corner alongside of Peck.
That's a beautiful kick.
Brings it across. It'll be played by Romero. Now the Black Knights will take that. And they'll send it across to the far side.
All sides.
Yep, bring it back around.
I think he was offsides before the ball got released.
Past the 10-minute mark, 1-0. We should remind you and remind you many times that we have a brand new site that's cooking. And it's pretty darn cool because we've got some of the best web people in the business. Mario, Jenny, the whole crew. Not forgetting about Maureen as well, as it's sent on the Black Knight net. And this will go back behind the net. But in any event, it's live.han.network. So go check it out. That's where you'll watch us. And the YouTube stream is also in play in various places. But, of course, we want you to go to live.han.network now. Check out everything. Far side for Jerry Philogene of the Black Knights. Off the throw-in comes to Patrick Tomaszak. With Greenwich leading 1-0. Are you a nil or nothing person?
I don't know. I think I would say zip, maybe.
Oh, zero? you're a zip person. Wow.
Or zero, goose egg.
Wow. Oh, wow. I'm all confused now.
Different sports, I think you have to adjust, right?
Exactly. As this goes over into the Cardinal bench. Off the throw-in, played by Greenwich. Now the Black Knights trying to work it down into that right corner, feeding it across, trying to get it into Peck. But it comes back out on the far end. Black Knights resetting. Cardinals take it away. Grabbed by the Knights into the corner. Fighting for it was Romero of Greenwich. It gets turned back the other way past Agudelo of the Cards. Of course, Walter Stewart's Market helps bring you these broadcasts. Pamby Motors, Bankwell, Carl Chevrolet, and Coastal Orthopedics. And I've said it forever, just at the very least, go let those nice people know that their business is appreciated, and of course give them some business regardless, but certainly let them know that it's great to have great companies supporting high school sports, and that's what it comes down to. I mean, I love talking about it. We all love doing it, but it's support, and it's these students, and that's what it comes down to. And it's certainly been fun for me to do it. Here it's 1-0 Greenwich, just about 13 minutes gone by. 1-0, 1-0, 1 goose egg.
Get them all in there.
Exactly. We'll work them all in. Andy Lewis for the Black Knights, now taken away. Cardinals moving from left to right. Across the line goes Nico Ortiz. Now back out near the mid-stripe. Taken by Ortiz. Soccer fans of all types are allowed here today. That's probably the cutest one here yet.
Baby Husky, right?
A baby, yeah, looked like a baby Husky. Here's the throw in, and there it is. Oh, look at that. That is cute. Nice work by Eric and AJ to get that shot. 1-0. Greenwich on top. On the far side. Played by Valladares. I sounded better that time. I sounded more confident when
That's
I said
right.
it.
That's right. I think if you just say it with confidence,
yes.
You know.
until I get that email saying that it was pronounced completely wrong, and then we reset from there. On the throw-in. And it's cleared all the way out by the Cardinals. Mike Ortiz will play it. He'll roll it along. This is one of the best crowds we've seen yet for a soccer or field hockey, for that matter. So just a really good turnout here today.
It's like a bunch of people from practice coming in, too.
Yeah. And, yeah, you want to see that. You know, you want to see your classmates and fellow athletes hanging around and supporting. As Bartles boots it all the way down into the Black Knight end. Reset and sent down the right side. Trying to steal it away, but out to slide it is Ortiz. Agutello was coming down that right side. But there was a defender there for Stamford. They trail 1-0. As we are into the 16th minute on a beautiful Tuesday afternoon here in Stamford. Now down the far side. Again, fans of all shapes, sizes, and cuteness here today.
Future stars.
Absolutely. That's a cutie. I believe that was number 18, future star. ...24 minutes remaining in the first half. Decked out in all red with the white numbers. Bounced right off a Cardinal. That Cardinal will take it right back. Kevin Romero for the Cardinals. Down the left side goes Peck, but it'll be a Cardinal to reach it first. That's Quiroga. They're battling down there in the corner.
No call there.
Nope. Able to reach it first was Jose Romero. Some good smells in this crowd, too, by the way. It's not smell-o-vision for those of you at home,
either?
But my gosh, the parking lot filled right in, too. Is there a food truck? Or somebody's making dinner in the houses back behind us as this goes high and over the net. We got some subs coming in. And it looks like Akira Dunham from what I can see for Greenwich. As well as Anthony Oliveras, a forward. Cardinals bringing it down the near side.
Good save.
McLean. Tumbling down goes Ortiz. Of course, as we know, and certainly you know from being a well-versed soccer fan, that a lot of diving goes on in this sport. Wasn't saying that in that spot. I'm just saying a lot of bodies do tumble.
Intense, and you only have shin guards on.
That's right.
Some people weren't wearing shin guards.
Here's Andy Lewis for the Black Knights. They are decked out in the white kit top with the black shorts, but the orange numbers. Orange has long been one of their accent colors. Black, of course, for the Black Knights. That was Bartles. Dunham for the Black, for the Cardinals, rather. Past the midway mark of the first half in a 1-0 game. Bartles, he grabs it back, bounces it off his body, was getting in close, and sends it off the side of the net. But a good look there for Nick Bartles. You can see why he's good, Raquel.
Oh, yeah. He actually had a position change this season. He was, I guess, a forward last year, and they switched him into midfield with the height he's got. That's a great position for someone tall, being able to see the field.
19 and a half remaining, first half. Raquel pressed into duty today. I'll explain that when we get a moment. The Black Knights moving, though, and bringing it down from right to left, trying to set it up off to the near side as it was played by Yuri Yosipiv. Excuse me. Tim Murphy was expected to work this game with me today, but, you know, Murph, along with Bill Bloxham, Mike Suppy, Rocco Veluzzo, when he's around, Steve Buno, of course, as well. You know, all these guys, sports editors, they still have newspapers to do as well, the quote-unquote real job. So Murph kind of gave the option of one game or the other, and we had Murph join us on camera yesterday at Ridgefield High School. So that meant he was unavailable today. Dave Stewart appeared for about a moment here today. He disappeared, but by that point, I had already drafted Raquel, and she was more than willing to jump in. And believe me, I am more than grateful for the company.
Thanks for having me. It's great.
Well, first of many. Here it comes right into the crowd and over the head of Bill Bloxham. No souvenirs for the fans here today. You got to throw them back. No souvenirs in baseball as well at high school level. You got to throw those back as well.
Too.
Yeah, you do.
Well, equipment expense. So probably can't take too much of the equipment.
Just bounces loose for a moment. A Cardinal slides down. That was Romero. 1-0 the score. Greenwich on top. As we bounce into the 23rd minute, Dunham will bring it in from the near side. Brings it into Zach Friedman. The junior in all red moving from left to right. Now he resets. Back come the Black Knights. Way out to play it comes Romero. And the whistle will turn it around. We'll get a couple of substitutions coming in. Luis Carrillo among those coming in for Greenwich. Greenwich 5-1-2 on the year for 17 points.
Their tie was actually against Stamford their first game of the season.
And that's just why it goes to show, you know, two good programs, and I really, sometimes, you know, the old Bill Parcells saying is you are what your record says, but, you know, sometimes that's not entirely true. I don't see this Black Knights team as being a 3-4 team right now.
Right, yeah.
Or 3-4-1 in this case. Played by Greenwich. Mendive, and I had visions of that ball coming right into the crowd. He was almost aimed right at us. Ariel Sandoval will throw it in for Stamford. They trail 1-0. 26th minute now on a beautiful Tuesday afternoon I shudder to think this could possibly be the last glimpse of such great weather. I hope not, but we are staring the depth of certainly fall right in the eye. Near side played by Victor Garage. 69 degrees as we sit here right now, just outside of Boyle Stadium.
It's a little warmer than that.
It does feel warmer, I agree. I think we bounced into the low 70s, but then again, you're not wrong if you grabbed yourself a vest or a sweater or something. It's one of those anything goes type of days. But as I got close to come out here today, I thought, no, shorts, gotta do it. One more time. Jose Romero will go for the goalie kick. Here he comes. Left footer makes the approach and boots it down. Stays in the Cardinal end, but Bartles grabs it. Bartles' size alone is impressive as a player.
Yeah.
Sends it down the left side. You know, the old men amongst boys type of thing. And I wouldn't necessarily go that far, but certainly as a player, he is impressive just in his size alone. And then his skill is just outstanding.
Does have a couple inches on everyone on the field, it looks like.
Yeah. Almost a collision right out near midfield. At times, you can spy the classic Black Knight logo, and they've had that logo for quite a while, that knight's mask and then the kind of the orange that goes off of the top of it.
Is that called a plume? Do you know what that's called?
It is a plume. 13:38 clock running, first half, 1-0 Greenwich. The Cardinals scored in the fifth minute. Be thrown back in. We'll get the bookkeeping at halftime. Greenwich will throw it in. Football will involve these very same Black Knights on Friday night. It will not be here at Boyle Stadium, but I can assure you we will be back at Boyle Stadium at least once and possibly twice. That's what we call a tease. But for sure, unless something really changes, down the right side it goes. Around a man. And the whistle will stop things. That was Terrell Williams. Nice move by him. 12:41 to go first half, 1-0. The FCAC Football Championship. The much discussed, the much beloved, certainly by me, will be played right here once again. Looking, I believe, at November 21st. Which would be fitting. And I'll explain why when time allows, and time might allow right now. November 21st is the official anniversary of the beginning of this enterprise that started out as Hearsum Acorn Radio, morphed into HAN Radio before it became the HAN Network. It was November 21st, 2013. Dave Stewart, Bill Bloxham, and I did an FCAC Championship football game preview show. 1 hour, that was our first day on the air. Then the following day, which happens to be some broadcaster's birthday, we did the FCAC Championship between New Canaan and St. Joe's. Yes, that was a birthday that either was going to be one of the great birthdays of my life or was going to be a day that I curled up in a fetal position. We were all so nervous about the very humble beginnings of this operation. But it has survived. 1-0, Greenwich on top. So we will be here November 21st for the FCAC Football Championship. Dunham for Greenwich. Sends it to Bartles. Nice feed to Bartles. And then the quick move down on net and diving on top of it, Mike Ortiz. But good ball movement by the Greenwich Cardinals.
It's great touches on the ball, too.
If I saw it correctly, that looked like number 9, Federico Irigoyen, that was down there. He had the best look at getting it in the net off that feed from Bartles, that little touch. This will come back down to Ortiz. You get a feel for the flow of the game so far?
It seems pretty evenly dominated as far as Stamford was dominating just a few minutes ago, keeping the ball over here and on their scoring territory. Now it seems Greenwich just got possession of it more.
Cardinals will bring it in. Here is the throw-in. Can't say enough about this crowd here today. All along the fence as well, and back behind us, the parking lot has filled in. Across the line, it gets turned back around. And certainly the fact that it's so geographically close for both these teams, the town's neighbors, they have not been big rivals in anything for quite a few years. Used to be more of a football rivalry between the two towns, city and town. Not as much. In fact, Greenwich and Stamford don't have a tendency to meet much on the gridiron these days. And at times that Stamford was up in basketball, well, Greenwich was not, and vice versa. Stamford, in fact, was coached on the basketball court by their now athletic director, Jim Moriarty. Had some good teams here at Stamford High in the early 2000s, at least when I first started seeing them. 9:11 to go before halftime.
Corner kick.
And the corner kick indeed is coming. Here it comes. Booted in. Bartles was down there, thrown down, and they score. Looking like it was Alejandro McLean, number 22, on that one. We'll confirm at halftime, but with 8:54 to go before the break, Greenwich has taken a 2-0 lead.
They always say corner kicks are the golden opportunity, so got a goal off that one.
So a good turn for the Cardinals, and they're up by two. Feeling the love here. Is that coming in the 23rd minute? Excuse me, in the 33rd minute. I'm good at math, it just sometimes takes a moment. Across the line it goes. You learn to get good at how to deal with time in a sporting event when you're a hockey announcer, because the time is always going up in what you write down for the time of the goal. But of course, in every arena you go into, the clock counts down, so you kind of get good at that math. Sent back the other way, back to grab it for Greenwich goes Dunham. There is some wind here today. In fact, it was just enough to concern us as we're under our tent. This gets blasted up over the net. There is a street back behind that fence. You can spy what looks almost like a school back there. In fact, there is a daycare center back there among apartments and other things. 7:35 to go first half. Connor McDonough checks in for the Black Knights. I mean no offense to anyone else when I say Connor McDonough might be the easiest name on the Stamford roster, just for me. And I mean that in the least offensive way possible, I promise.
There's no silent letters.
Do not be frightened by the appearance of Christopher Callen. As my partner Cato has just come in. Cato and I worked the Fairfield Ward Staples football game on Friday night last week. Coming down to 6.5 to go in the first half, 2-0 Greenwich. As it gets pooched back into the Greenwich end. Black Knights have had a few chances. The Cardinals have just had the better opportunities. A collision out there with Ali SMA. The Black Knights have lost to St. Joe's, Darien, Brian McMahon, and Danbury. Those were their losses on the year. They beat Norwalk, New Canaan, and Trinity Catholic. Whistle stops the play. Under 6 to go in the half. So Ortiz resets. Black Knights moving it along to the far side. Now Greenwich will bring it back. Black Knights are there as they start to turn around. They could use a goal right here before halftime. Under 6 to go in the half. Bounced off the body. I believe that was Dunham. A 5-on-5. Esalame and Dunham here at the other end. Good chance for Greenwich. Good save coming out to play at Ortiz. McLean and Fikray holding their heads on that missed opportunity. Under 5 to go in the half. 2-0 Greenwich. Great camera work by Bill Bloxham in that corner. As you're watching the camera, I believe, of Marty Hersom as it comes in.
Stamford may have an opportunity.
Stamford does have an opportunity. It gets away. And not the greatest work right there as it goes well wide of the net. But the Black Knights with a good chance right there. So Dunham for Greenwich. Gets redirected by Francesco Ninavag. Close enough?
Ninavagi,
excuse me. I was talking to him before the game, actually, and he was saying to me how he transferred here from Trinity. He was pretty excited to get on the broadcast today. So, Francesco, if I said your name wrong, I apologize, but... We gave it a good go. But, yeah, we were chatting very early. There was a point where it was just myself, Tracy Iazzi, Francesco, and Mario Caminiti, the head coach for Stamford. Those are always some of the nicer moments when you get to the field and it's very quiet, you and just a few others. And, you know, you like the opportunities to be able to talk about sports or anything else for that matter.
Did you get any game details?
You know, nothing I can expand upon. It's all private information. Yeah. Here comes the throw-in. Bounced away from Bartles. I mentioned before how well Bartles played in the other game that we had Greenwich in. That was against the Wilton Warriors. It was the Nick Bartles show that day.
He had a hat trick in that game, right?
He did. He did. That's why I tend to not wear hats to games like that, because I don't want to lose any. As it goes down on net and played by Romero. I like my hats too much. I don't want to throw them. Of course, that's very much a hockey thing. We keep getting closer to that date when we get our first look at those winter schedules. Back to play at Ariel Sandoval. Sends it back down to net where Ortiz sends it back out to midfield. Salome down the near side now gets it to McDonough. McDonough wearing 15, pooches it across. And Zachary Friedman was able to send it back. Or actually, that was Luis Carrillo as it goes down and pushed aside. Best save of the day coming from Jose Romero. 1:49 to go, first half. 2-0. Off the throw-in from the corner. That got sent high up onto the fencing behind that cage. And of course, you want that to be triple high because you'd be losing plenty of soccer balls out into the street. It's actually a school in New Jersey that plays their games on top of the school. On the roof is an artificial turf field, so you need those high fences for that very reason.
Be a long chase to shag that ball.
Yeah, exactly. As that goes out to the far side, 106 to go first half. Football Friday from Danbury High School as the Danbury Hatters host the Stamford Black Knights. Pre-game action starting at 4. And we'll have the call for you at 7. Chris Irway and I back together. Cato can't be with me that week anyway, so. I enjoyed working with Cato. It's about time. He knows I was happy. Half minute to go in the half. I'm happiest when I get to work with both Cato and Chris Irway, two of my closer friends. It's back out to play. It comes Ortiz. Out the center it goes. Gets sent down across into the right side. Flavian Lolo was there for Greenwich. Down to 14 in the half. Ninivaji waiting on the near side. Sends it back near the net. Sent out to the far. Down to 2-1. Should be enough to end the first half. And it is. So Stamford will see if they can fix things, but the Greenwich Cardinals, I wouldn't say they're content, but they're certainly pleased to be up 2-0 here at the half. What do you think?
Yeah, I think Stamford's got to get after the next half of the game. They got to really go and attack more. They've had opportunities, they just haven't been able to seal them.
So we're at the end of the first half, and the Greenwich Cardinals lead the Stamford Black Knights 2-0 just outside of Boyle Stadium. We'll all take a break here, and we will come back for some halftime stuff, get all the bookkeeping scores, everything you need to know as we move along on a beautiful Tuesday afternoon from here in Stamford. We pause for a break. You're watching the FCAC on the HAN Network.
Connecticut is coming back to hometown banking, to a partner that makes small businesses feel big, where community comes first, where high-tech tools go hand-in-hand with a human touch, where you get the know-how only neighbors can deliver, where saving time is important too. It's time to expect more. It's time to bank well. Bank smart. Bank local. Bank well.
When you experience a sports injury, you want to get better and fast. Coastal Ortho Express gives you direct access to orthopedic care quickly. Their physicians are fellowship trained in sports medicine at world-class universities and are also team doctors for area football teams. For specialized personal care of sports injuries, go to Coastal Ortho Express. Open Monday through Saturday in the iPark building, 761 Main Avenue in Norwalk, or coastalorthoexpress.com. Coastal Orthopedics, keeping you on the move.
Back to school means back to busy, and Stewart's Market can save you precious time by stocking all of your favorite essentials under one roof. For a healthy start to school, we have all the ingredients. Walter Stewart's, your family-owned fresh local market, 229 Elm Street and at stewartsmarket.com.
Football University, the nation's leading football training experience, is now accepting applications for its 2015 camps. Our elite faculty of NFL coaches and top professionals teach position-specific on the field and in the classroom to improve your football IQ and help you reach your full potential as a player. Apply today at footballuniversity.org. Football University, where technique plus talent beats talent alone.
Healthy, confident smiles begin at Stratford Orthodontics. Conveniently located on Main Street, we are Stratford's hometown orthodontist. We offer the latest in orthodontic technology, including Damon braces and Invisalign. We always accept new patients. Call today to schedule a complimentary consultation. 203-375-8332. Stratford Orthodontics, 2499 Main Street, Stratford. 203-375-8332. 375-8332 and online at StraffordSmile.com.
While the temperatures are cooling down, the fall bite is heating up. Albies, bonita, blackfish, alligator blues, and stripers are following the large schools of bait that are abundant in the Long Island Sound. If you love the New England coast during autumn, this is the time to be on the water. The latest from Shimano, Quantum, Avet, Hoagie, Phase 2 and more are in stock and ready to go at the dock shop. And don't mind those fall breezes with jackets, hats, gloves, and fleece from Grundon's and Stormer. The dock shop will keep you warm and dry. Boater, beach bum, fisherman, or simply love the New England coast, this is a unique place to shop. The dock shop, now in two locations, 51 Tokenique Road, Darien, 609 Riverside Avenue, Westport, or on the web, dockshop.com.
Have no fear. HAN Network's Fast Frights movie contest is here. Can your film make the cut? Submit your 3-minute scary movie today for a chance to win a DJI Phantom 3 drone. Sponsored by Milford Photo. The only thing to fear is missing the deadline.
Alliance. We are an industry leader in coordinating transportation for large events such as corporate road shows, conferences, and special events. Our team of experts understands the dynamics and logistics of high-pressure situations and complex arrangements, all within a rapidly changing environment. Since 1999, we have added charter jets, event management, and personal protection to our range of services. Mention this ad for $25 off your next round-trip reservation. Alliance and you. Together, we can achieve the extraordinary. 855-546-6996 or AllianceLimo.com.
Does buying a car leave you feeling like you're chasing your tail? Head straight to Pamby Chrysler Jeep Dodge and Ram and take car buying in a whole new direction.
Kaikout Rockefeller Estate is Westchester County's top cultural attraction and is now open for the season. Don't miss out. Go online to hudsonvalley.org to plan your visit. Take a drive out to beautiful Sleepy Hollow, New York, and enjoy Kaikout's stunning architecture, breathtaking gardens, expansive art galleries, and commanding Hudson River views. From world-class art by Picasso and Warhol to expertly tended gardens, there's something for everyone. Kaikout Rockefeller Estate, a National Trust for Historic Preservation Landmark.
Carl Chevrolet is proud to sponsor HAN Network's coverage of the area's best high school sports. No matter the sport, competition in the FCAC is spirited, so get out and cheer on your favorite team. If you can't make it to the game, be sure to bring HAN Network with you to keep up with the action. Visit Carl Chevrolet in New Canaan or online at carldirect.com.
Just outside of Boyle Stadium, we're at halftime. 2-0, Greenwich on top. Now we've got the scoring resolved, and look, the honesty is that Nick Bartles is going to get credit for the first Greenwich goal, but the reality is it was an own goal scored by Stamford, but Bartles gets credit. So that made it 1-0 in the 5th minute, and then McLean in the 32nd minute makes it 2-0 at that point. And sort of a guest, as long as he sticks around, is our good friend and colleague, Christopher Kaling. Cato, good afternoon.
Good afternoon, guys.
Your thoughts as you join us?
The one thing I've seen so far from the little bit I've been able to see is Stamford High is having a hard time getting out in front of Greenwich and getting traffic in front of the net. And I think for them is they're getting the opportunities, but they're just not getting ahead of the Greenwich defense to get clear shots at the goal. Again, Greenwich is just doing a great job cutting the ball off.
You know, the way you're talking, it sounds like you're talking about hockey. I'm getting confused just because you and I are normally sitting together for a hockey game.
Well, yeah. But, I mean, more importantly, you like to see physical contact,
yes,
in front of the net.
Yes.
But you're not going to get that here.
No, you're not going to. You shouldn't be crashing the net here anyway.
No. Never mind. Just
no.
Let it go.
And Raquel, so far, your thoughts? I mean, you had a chance to kind of walk across the field. Could you get a feel for either team, the mood or anything like that?
I think Greenwich is pretty much thinking that they have the game in the bag. It seems Stamford was coming up with a new strategy over there, trying to figure out how they could get a goal possibly in the next few minutes and really start to attack the Greenwich defense.
Again, 2-0 here at halftime, and, you know, a big lead for sure, but the Black Knights can do it, and they had chances in the first half.
They did have good opportunities. Some of the shots were a little wide on goal and just didn't really get to, you know, they have a good goalie.
Now, you came in late, you know. Can you get a sense for the Black Knights?
It looks as if, I think, whether their confidence is there because they're not afraid to take their shots and they're getting their opportunities to take them. But it's more, like I said, it's being able to get players into the spaces to give those easy opportunities for goals. I think it's more you have to converge on the goal and get the goaltender looking away from certain individuals to create the scoring opportunities, to create the passes to make things happen.
We will come back for the second half with Greenwich up by 2. Bartles and McLean, the goal scorers. Second half gets underway right after this. You're watching the FCAC on the HAN Network.
It's time to come back to hometown banking, where people are taken into account, not just balances. Where community comes first. A place where there's more than one kind of interest. Where automation will never replace consideration. Where they not only know your name, they know your dog's name too. It's time to expect more. It's time to bank well. Bank smart. Bank local. Bank well.
Almost time for the second half, just outside of Michael Boyle Stadium, which is the more formal name. Very few actually remember who Mr. Boyle was. But there's some wonderful history of the stadium on the Stamford High School Athletics website. He was an athletic director and a football coach at Stamford High School. And the project was a New Deal project, a WPA project to be exact, and opened, as I said, in the 1930s. But that is for football season when we do come back and visit Boyle Stadium for at least one, if not two, football games in the very near future. 2-0 our score. Black Knights all on a knee as they talk through things. And they get ready to go here in the second half. Cardinals all standing down to our right. Gathered in their group.
Stamford's now going to be playing, looking into the sun now. Is it? It's going to be setting over their eyes. Probably have a difficult time seeing the field.
Yeah, it will create problems for the defense and scoring opportunities for Greenwich. If Greenwich can get the ball up in the air, it makes it harder, that much harder to see.
Indeed, this field does go from east to west, if you will. East is to our left, so you're moving right across, and of course the sun therefore would be setting to your right.
I played a lot of years on the baseball field down below, and I know playing left field at this time of year, even toward the late May, early June, it was that sun right in your face.
Yeah.
Second half underway, and the Cardinals control it. It does, by the way, look like two new goalies are in net, one for each team, but I believe both teams have changed their goalies, their keepers. I can't confirm that for you, but because as I've mentioned before, and this is something that still, I admit, is new to me, you know, most of the time you don't list a number for your keeper. So there isn't a roster number, it just says GK on the roster.
We're really allowed to have two numbers by the SEAC, a field number and a goalie number.
Right. That is true. But second half underway. Here's the boot down into the Stamford zone. As we mentioned, Stamford now moving from left to right. Bounces across the line. Bartles, just so pretty with the ball movement from Nick Bartles. Gets down and comes over into the near corner. Irigoyen there for Greenwich. They lead 2-0, a minute and a half gone by in the second half. With Raquel Welsh, Chris Callen, A.J. Simonowski, Eric Gendron, Marty Hersom, Tracy Iazzi, Josh Fisher, Bill Bloxham. I'm Rob Adams. Glad you're along on what is just a stunningly beautiful afternoon.
I know there has been discussion about going a lot higher with that fence.
Has there really?
Yeah, there has been. Maybe a netting or something up over the top.
Back it comes with the Cardinals. Moving from right to left. Aguadello down the near side. Around a man goes Lolo. Lolo toward the corner. Had it pushed aside by Yosipov. Irigoyen, the sophomore, will go grab it. He'll set up shop from the near corner. A little obscured from our view. Marty can see it from his camera as you're watching it. And in it comes. Cardinals unable to convert. But for our perspective, you have the better view than we do. Shots being called up by Eric, and then Marty, Bill, and AJ making them work via the camera. But our perspective, a little off cue. Throw in from the opposite corner now by Greenwich. Bartles, wearing number 3, sends it down, and the Black Knights able to clear it back. Greenwich keeps the pressure on, though. Aguadello there, wearing number 7. Black Knights looking to return fire. Trying to set up shop again. Federico Marine. A little hint of shadow right out near midfield coming off that tree that's just behind the Black Knight bench. And the Cardinals will come out of that shadow. Into the corner they go. Near the corner. But the whistle will spin it around. 4 minutes gone as we enter minute number 5. Greenwich up by 2.
Greenwich is very aggressive going after the ball. Anybody having the ball in their possession, they're going right in to take it away. They're not giving Stamford High any space. Not even, you can't even tell a defensive zone. It just looked like they're, you could say, man coverage.
Here's Bartles. Bartles uses the left foot to bring it forward. But Ariel Sandoval for the Black Knights almost gives Marty Hersom a present. Wanted to make sure Marty followed his own advice that he's given to the whole staff, but really more so to the camera people. And this dates back to our baseball coverage back really in May and June, where it was made very clear, if the ball is coming toward the camera, your body is the first thing you will protect. Get out of the way of the ball. Don't worry about the equipment. I'm not so sure Marty would do the same in this spot.
Wasn't Marty wearing a glove when he was working the cameras?
You never know. Andy Lewis for the Black Knights. Sends it from left to right. Back goes Dunham, the junior, for Greenwich. This will go up into the trees and almost down to where the great Bobby Augustine coached a lot of baseball for a lot of years. Cato, I know that's a guy you know pretty well.
Yeah, Coach Augustine, almost a fixture at Stamford High for a lot of years, especially during the spring. And even during the fall, he still announces the football games.
Yes, he does. Well, he took over for Leon Javen, who was the long, long time voice of Boyle Stadium. He was still working games when I first started, and then Bobby jumped in. So the goal kick coming. Into the 8th minute we go. 2-0 Greenwich. Headed forward by Garage for the Black Knights. Off to the far side it goes, and Andy Lewis has it go off his foot out of bounds. Four Football coming up Friday. FC ACT tailgate gets it all started at 4. Where that broadcast takes place to be determined, but the site itself is otherwise known. It's just, you know, will we be in the rig? Where will we be? It's almost kind of a Where's Waldo thing. Over to the near side come the Greenwich Cardinals. So 4 o'clock for the tailgate, FC ACT game day at 5, and then Stamford and Danbury. We promise we have hopes of a good game this Friday. We're kind of 0 for 3 on the good game factor in football. Actually 0 for 4 if you count our very first game, which was, as it's turned over, chance from McLean. Correction, I will say we're 1 for 5 on good football games. I thought Weston and Notre Dame of Fairfield was a decent game, but Yorktown and John Jay was not so good to get us started. And the FCAC games, well, sent across. So Stamford and Danbury on Friday night, Crotty Stadium in Danbury, 7 o'clock. Chris Irway and I on the call. Someday we will see you, Cato, and actually have a sideline reporter again.
It would be nice. I just got to work out the schedule.
The wonderfully amazing Chrissy Kalen, Cato's long-suffering wife.
Don't say long-suffering. She got a new truck.
Chrissy and I have been buddies for a while. This goes down on net. But Chrissy's got to give her blessing to let Cato get away from Karen and Ashley. Shane, if he's around.
Oh, no, Shane's not around.
Shane's not around these days?
Buford. He's back in Buford.
I don't know these things. Down the right side. Yeah, but you got Abby Dabby, the dog. That's all we need.
I could bring Abby with us.
Abby's funny. 2-0 here as we're in the 10th minute, second half. I know technically it's the 50th minute, but work with me here.
Yeah, you got to have to... You got to clean
soccer,
that up.
Because soccer lingo.
I'm working on this stuff.
Yeah. Well, didn't you watch the cup games?
My God, they have soccer on your YES Network all the time. All the time.
You know, I don't watch a lot of the YES Network after, say, October 1st.
And they play soccer on Jeter Field down in the Bronx.
And? Jeter Field, listen to this.
Well, if Irwan was around, he'd say because they do play it in the Jerry Dome in Dallas.
I thought Irwan, and Irwan is a nickname for Chris Irway. I think he is going to a game very soon at Jerry Dome,
at
Jerry World.
Dome.
Sent across, the Black Knights have it. Trying to get on the board, they're down 2. As we have 10 minutes gone by in the second half, just about. More people gathering on the back of the press box.
Seeing Stanford's strategy is more passing this half the game. A lot of crosses and a lot of square passes.
It really seems like they really are trying to get a presence in front of the net, in front of the goal, and keep the goalkeeper busy that way. It's just Greenwich's defense has just been too good for it.
Yeah.
Greenwich still up 2, off the throw-in from the Greenwich bench. Goes down into that far corner. Luis Carrillo there. Substitutions now coming on. That's for the Black Knights. It looks like Ninavaji has come back in.
Another guy Rob likes because he has great hair.
No, you've got the hair. I mean, you know, we're getting soaked to our skin on Friday night. And again, Cato and I took our fair share of rain and cold. Nobody took it worse than AJ or John Kovach. I will readily admit that. And those guys did an outstanding job of keeping us going all night as it comes over to the near side. But Cato was out in the rain trying to, at times, help pack things up. And you would just think his hair was, I mean, it was unaffected by it. It's impressive.
Must be a hair product that you use, right?
I don't use a lot. Not as much as you think.
It's more than Rob?
Yeah, that I can promise you. I've told this story before, and it is a true story. I absolutely made the decision on my hair to cut it as short as I did because of headphones. It is 100% true. I wear them so often to do what I do here. To the far side it goes. That was Ibra Diallo for the Black Knights. They trail 2-0. As we're coming up on the 53rd minute of this game. Greenwich on goals by Bartles and McLean. I've already gotten at least one text regarding Bartles and something else from a lifetime ago. And those of us old enough to get that joke, just leave it there. Pooched over to the near side, right out in front of A.J. Szymanowski.
And on that turnover, you see Ninavaji, he had a great shot at the goal. The ball went off his foot just the wrong way and out of bounds. And you see you could see the Stamford High head coach Mario Caminiti just holding his head. He's just frustrated because I think that's the way the game's gone so far.
Down the near side comes Greenwich. Irigoyen almost had a goal earlier, missed a good opportunity. But the Black Knights will take it back to the near side. Diallo worked it ahead. Valladares. Near side for Lolo of Greenwich. Across the line it goes for McLean. Turns around, feeds it ahead. Aguadelo off to his left for Irigoyen. And no harm out in front of the Stamford net. In a 2-0 game, Bartles tried to take it away from Valladares. I'm sounding more confident on those names. Yeah, a little bit better.
Yeah.
Thanks, Raquel.
You practice. I saw you practicing during halftime.
See, Cato, this is a lesson for you. Raquel went and got pronunciations.
I don't know if you can read them or not. I phonetically wrote them out with dashes and lines.
Okay. Now, I've done that for you.
Yes, you have.
When I've worked the sideline.
Yes, you have.
It is, you know, your other sidekick, the independently wealthy.
Leave Chris Irway alone. I'm going to play traffic cop between the two of you. 25-40 remaining in this one. 2-0 Greenwich. The simple fact for those who don't know, we're all friends, and that's part of it, as it was thrown down on net. Yes, I know I said thrown down again. It was an expression,
can't
folks.
Use your hands and
yes, I know.
Get him.
I do know.
Get him.
Be quiet, Cato. Across the line come the Black Knights. Off to the near side and out.
Well, they're getting opportunities. They're just not really executing them.
Flavian Lolo will bring it in for Greenwich. A junior. A very junior-laden team for Kurt Putnam. Bartles, needless to say, a senior captain, has the band on. Kind of shakes his head. We have a good look at him right now. You can see the captain's armband. Greenwich will reset now with McLean. Sends it across to Dunham. Dunham moves it forward, but instead stolen away by Ninavaji. Now the throw-in. Ninavaji plays it right off his chest out in front of his own bench, and it'll go to the bench. Coming up on the 17th minute of the second half. In a 2-0 game, there's Bartles for Greenwich to the near side. Stolen away in front of a good crowd here, many cameras in the crowd. And certainly a great afternoon to be here and enjoying it. Temperatures hovering around the low 70s. thrown back for Greenwich. McLean there sets with the right foot, sends it down toward his own bench. Off the throw in, Ninavaji. Bringing it across, Lolo for Greenwich. Had it stolen away. Federico Marine for Stamford. Lolo and Marine getting into it, into the corner. Two nil set. Greenwich scored in the 5th minute and the 32nd minute. Turned over and the Cardinals will take it. McLean, now fake Ray, gets down, ball loose, looking for another try. Coming down was Jose Sierra. A little note to bring along to you, and if you're watching, whether it be on the YouTube channel or on our new site, brand new, I mean, just took the wraps off of it today, live.han.network. If you're watching in, Texas, Minnesota, or wherever you may be, we hope you're enjoying the sights and sounds of Stamford, Connecticut on a beautiful Tuesday afternoon. Your broadcasting crew on this Tuesday. Chris Callen alongside of us here in the second. Always love finding out those far and away viewers and listeners. We still have that great story that we tell from the Babe Ruth tournament, the New England Babe Ruth tournament that took place at Stamford. We had viewers in New Zealand. In our first year of doing just radio audio only for the FCAC Hockey Championship, we had a listener checking out his grandson from all the way first in San Diego and then from a plane 35,000 feet in the air. So, been a little bit everything.
Dedicated fans.
Exactly. To head to the far side, across the line, over to Black Knight setting things up with Tomziak, and it goes over the net. Substitution coming in for Greenwich. That's Fermin Mendave coming in for the Greenwich Cardinals. Booted back out and across the line. Jose Sierra was there for Greenwich. He got knocked forward a little bit. And the Black Knights will take it. Fed across, waiting. Valladares had his pocket picked. Flavian Lolo, and a little love for Federico Irigoyen, because that's what fans will do. Of course, you know, the classic line uttered by Derek Jeter was, well, whenever I hear them booing, I just think they're cheering. I always thought that was a pretty good approach.
Well, everybody booed him in every other ballpark.
Boy, if that's the case, Alex Rodriguez is the most popular player to ever live.
He was even booed in his own ballpark.
Yeah, sure was. A-Rod and the Yankees have some work to do tonight at the stadium as they back their way into hosting a playoff game in the Bronx. Masahiro Tanaka gets the start for the Yankees in tall order against Dallas Keuchel of the Astros, who they have not hit well at all. That's later tonight down in New York.
I think the stat on
correct. That's correct. Doesn't pitch well on the road otherwise. To the near side come the Black Knights with Valladares. Takes a look. Got to start with one. Ninavaji there for the Black Knights. Yep. Taken by the Cardinals now. little connection between Jose Diera and Diallo.
I think Stanford's starting to realize they don't have much more time.
Yeah, I would think you'd probably be, if not even sooner than this, you're at the point where I think you got to get a little more aggressive and a certain amount of desperation, Raquel.
I think they're starting to show that aggressiveness. It's just Greenwich playing too well on defense, shutting it down.
Under 18 to go. Second half, 2-0. Substitution coming in for Greenwich. Stamford will sub as well. At least they're planning on it. Matthias Hoekstra comes in for the Cardinals. On the near side waits Irigoyen. Here's the throw-in by Greenwich. Resetting in the Black Knight zone. And ahead it goes. Taken by McLean, and it rolls in. McLean with his second. 3-0 Greenwich.
And this play pretty much starts with the Greenwich clear. Stamford tries to get it quickly back into the zone, and it's just intercepted and taken straight to the net. Once he gets out ahead of the Stamford D, it was all over.
So 3-0 Greenwich. And now that long way back. Coming up on about 16 and a half to go. By the way, want to make sure we give a mention to, I believe it was JJ, who was handling security here before the game. Just want to mention him because very helpful in allowing us to set up and get the rig, the HAN Cruiser 2.0, settled in. I love calling it the 2.0, even though, you know, within a matter of months, it'll be the only cruiser we've ever really known. Back the other way come the Cardinals. Nice job to take it away, though. Sliding in was Diallo. And there's a Cardinal down.
I have a rolled ankle.
I thought that was McLean, but
that's what it looks like.
Double check the number in a moment. Quickly over.
Yeah, that's McLean, Rob.
Yosipov comes over to check on him. Clock stops with 15:53 remaining. Second half, 3-0 Greenwich. They will tend to him. While they tend to McLean, why don't we take a timeout from here just outside of Boyle Stadium with our score in boys soccer, Greenwich on top of Stamford, 3-0. You're watching the FCAC on the HAN Network.
Means back to busy, and Stewart's Market can save you precious time by stocking all of your favorite essentials under one roof. For a healthy start to school, we have all the ingredients. Walter Stewart's, your family-owned fresh local market, 229 Elm Street and at stewartsmarket.com.
The fall buds and stripers are following the large schools of bait in the Long Island Sound. This is the time to visit the New England coast, and the Dock Shop can get you outfitted with the latest fishing gear, jackets, hats, gloves, and fleece. Boater, beach bum, fishermen simply love the New England coast. This is a unique place to shop. The Dock Shop, now in two locations, 51 Tokenique Road, Darien, 609 Riverside Avenue, Westport, or on the web, dockshop.com.
And back in Stamford with Raquel Welsh, Chris Callen, and our entire crew. I'm Rob Adams. 3-0 Greenwich. McLean helped off to his bench. Hobbling, he does take a seat over near the water cooler where they will tend to him. And the Stamford Black Knights try to get back to business. As the sun begins to fade here, and it's still very much in play, you can begin to feel a much cooler breeze here. If at times, and it's been bound to happen, if you've spied a body walking, or just something walking right across the camera, we are occupying the bleachers here today. So one of our cameras, the one that AJ is running, and AJ does look scary, I admit, but as much as he does look like a bodyguard, folks need to get past here. So it's a main access way for these grandstands. So certainly people have been allowed to walk across. We don't want to infringe upon them.
So mean to AJ, such a handsome devil.
I wasn't knocking his looks. I'm not afraid of him personally.
I did think he was security.
That's true.
You know, it's the pack that he has for the equipment. Rob makes him out to be riding around on a Segway like Paul Blart.
Thrown down. Considering I have no use for Kevin James, that I'm not even going there. It was a good chance for the Black Knights. They couldn't convert, and Bartles is just waiting. Good job to take it away from Bartles. That was done by Yosipov. Coming up on 14 minutes to play, 3-0 Greenwich. Still pondering some of those trivia questions, Cato, that the scoreboard operator was throwing at us Friday night. Some of them while we were on the air in Westport.
I'm surprised we didn't get tweets about it.
This comes over into the crowd. Well, he was asking, yeah, exactly. A couple of them were while we were on the air, but there was a whole bunch thrown at us at halftime.
Can you imagine that, just having the answers tweeted at us?
Yeah.
Thanks, guys.
I was pretty tired for that game. I mean, we got through the broadcast, and it was a fun night, but oof. Bounces down. Oh, the ball is loose. Hanging up there a long time, and there's Bartles. Now comes over near side. Flavian Lolo for Greenwich. Trying to get around Philip Peck of the Black Knights. There are the Cardinals again. Fermi Mendiv. Off to the far side it goes. Coming back out near midfield. From left to right goes Stamford. Greenwich up by 3. Zachary Friedman for the Knights. Back to Lolo. Little feed to Bartles, but turned over, and the Black Knights will take it back. Now it's the Cardinals. Off to the left, Lolo waiting, heading down toward that left corner. Trying to get around to Ariel Sandoval. And the throwing coming from the corner. Looks like Irigoyen will go down there for Greenwich. Up 3 with 12 and a half to play. Throws in to Bartles. Bartles got tripped up for a moment, jumps right back up. Black Knights return fire. Near side, Williams for the Black Knights. Across it goes for Greenwich. Paul Ruh, a junior. Now Bartles. Bartles and sent wide by Irigoyen.
Bartles with just a little too much toe on that shot.
kind of see it all the time.
Returning into the Stamford zone.
Yes, you did.
Many having to shade their eyes now as that afternoon sun begins to fade. And it'll be sent back toward Federico Marin of Stamford, had it knocked away from him by Jose Sierra of Greenwich. Bouncing down toward Hoekstra of Greenwich. Returned by Lolo. Lolo went back to grab it, and now we get a whistle and a Black Knight, a little shaken up. 11:14 to go, second half, 3-0 Greenwich.
It looks like it's Ninavaji on the, I guess he may have pulled something on the jump.
Or a cramp possible, the way they're working on him, just kind of stretching out that right leg. And again, we always make sure we don't try to speculate too much, but just based on what you're watching, and certainly out comes the water bottle, that seems like a classic cramp or Charlie horse. Which always reminds me of the way that this operation began. I barely knew Marty Hersom and had a Charlie horse in the middle of a softball game. Marty was an EMT at one time. So who comes to my rescue in the middle of that softball game? You got it. The guy who barely knew me, one Martin Hersom. Next thing you know, an hour or so later, we're chatting about starting an online radio station that morphed into this. While they work on Ninavaji, we will take a timeout. We've got just about 11 minutes to play. 3-0. Greenwich on top. You're watching the FCAC on the HAN Network.
Back to school means back to busy, and Stewart's Market can save you precious time by stocking all of your favorite essentials under one roof. For a healthy start to school, we have all the ingredients. Walter Stewart's, your family-owned fresh local market, 229 Elm Street and at stewartsmarket.com.
Football University, the nation's leading football training experience, is now accepting applications for its 2015 camps. Our elite faculty of NFL coaches and top professionals teach position-specific on the field and in the classroom to improve your football IQ and help you reach your full potential as a player. Apply today at footballuniversity.org. Football University, where technique plus talent beats talent alone.
3-0 Greenwich. As play begins, gets set to resume. Resetting things. Now the Black Knights will start. And over to the near side it comes. Greenwich able to move it back the other way. Zachary Friedman. Friedman and Bartles, the captains for Kurt Putnam and the Greenwich Cardinals. As they move down, this will roll away and be brought right back to this side. But very quickly, in comes Lolo flying in. You can hear the whole crowd trying to basically say, here he comes. Instead, it'll be the Black Knights moving it forward. Victor Garage there for the Black Knights. Fed across it comes. Coming up on 10 minutes to play in the second half. Friedman off into the corner it goes. That clock very much the enemy of the Stamford Black Knights. Thrown in from the corner by Stamford. Black Knights grab it and send it wide. No damage done.
Two excellent scoring opportunities for Stamford. Yeah, Giraj with the lead pass. Tried to get it across, just couldn't connect with anybody. And an excellent scoring opportunity right here, just sent wide.
That clock ticking down. Back out across the midfield stripe. That sun becoming more of an issue here, certainly for everyone. Shadows on the other side where the players are. nearly tripped up over there. A couple of players almost going down. Greenwich will reset back in their own end. And the immediate boot back out to midfield. Waiting there was Henry Lewis of Greenwich, a senior. More substitutions on the way. More soccer next Monday at Fairfield Ludlow. Norwalk Bears and the Fairfield Ludlow Falcons. Looks like Victor Garage being tended to. And of course, football coming up this Friday. Yes, the F-O-O-T type.
American.
Yes, the American football. Of course, American football was played on a traditional soccer pitch last weekend over in the UK. And an NFL coach lost his job as a result of it.
I wonder, did he fly home with the Dolphins? Did he, or did he have to catch his own flight?
I don't know. I'm sure Joe Philbin flew home with the team and then was summoned to Miami on Monday, where he was indeed fired.
Right to the principal's office.
Pretty much. 8:57 remaining in this one, 3-0. Sent down into the Greenwich end. Greenwich looking to spin it back the other way, but the Black Knights trying to keep the pressure on. Here comes Greenwich. Well wide. Just a little bit of a ridge that goes beyond that fence there down to the street. A slight slope.
Rob, with the vernacular savvy description of it, I just call it a cliff.
Sudden drop off.
Coming out of the corner. You just prefer me loquacious, right?
Let's that's a great story.
I know it is. Sent back by the Black Knights. Williams there. Now to be retrieved by Stamford. They're able to turn it around. Comes over to the near side. Vijay Kadiala will throw it in for Greenwich. Clock runs down, so that's why I give you the 7:20 remaining in this one. If the vernacular not quite what you want it to be, it's just taking a quick look at the clock and saying there's 7:12 to go. Off to the near side. Now Greenwich able to return with Joshua Wood. Greenwich moving from right to left. They're in the red. Stamford in their traditional white, orange, and black. Working around the man is Philogene. Greenwich, yep, Greenwich just a little ahead of the play. Henry Lewis, along with Mendy. 6:28 to go. As we get closer to the 85th minute. I promised when I took on calling soccer that Ian Dark's role is mighty safe. JP Della Camera and some of these other great soccer voices. Down the right side for Greenwich. They send it back toward their net. Under six to go. Ball loose out near midfield. What do you work on now if you're the Black Knights?
Well, you got to work on your, I guess, strategy for games going forward. You got to work on your passing and composure. It's tough when you're in a situation like this, only a few minutes left, three goals down.
Obviously, you know, I mean, you know, a game is never truly in doubt, but down three, it's a long road. Can you get yourself mentally to a point where you're trying to work on things in the balance of this game right here?
Mentally, it's probably a lot more challenging. I'd say that physically, they're, you know, some of them are exhausted. I mean, just within the last few minutes, we've had, you know, some cramps and some injuries. I think right now a lot of them are working on their touches. That'd be probably, you know, Greenwich, they haven't backed off their pressures last few minutes of the game.
No. They're up three with under five to go. Joshua Wood was there for Greenwich, wearing number 13. Taken away by Kadiala. Nice little touch to get it back the other way by James Huber. Coming down to 4 minutes to go. Greenwich just trying to keep things moving, and you're right, they really have not let up. Shadows now beginning to descend on the west side of this soccer facility.
Well, the sun's starting to go behind the apartment complex just beyond the school.
And more importantly, behind Boyle Stadium. Still, for my money, just about my favorite place to call a game from.
You miss the old press box, though.
I do. You're right. I will not deny that. It goes up behind the net. The old press box, which was on the opposite side of where the new press box is, so now on what would be the far side from our vantage point in Boyle Stadium, you hovered so close to the field and had such a great view. Now it was tight in there. It was two rows in there, one higher up than the other. And a coach's room that I got to broadcast out of several times, and that was a great view as well. Far side it goes. Cardinals have it. Keeping things on. Now it's the Black Knights. Connor McDonough. McDonough coming over to play it. Instead, it bounces loose. Change in net, in fact, for the Black Knights. So Justin Wexler, Michael Ortiz, and Alex Grabar are the three for the Black Knights. This will come over to the near side.
It's a nice kick.
2.5 to go. This gets moved over into the left corner.
He sends more kicks out like that, Jamar Green may come and talk to him.
Some NFL teams might want to talk to him as well. A lot of kicking problems in the NFL these days.
It's the adjustment they have to make to the new changes.
Yeah. Coming out of this near corner, we are down to 2:02 remaining. 3-0 Greenwich. Ball loose. Black Knights are able to send it back out. To the far side. Now go over the collection of duffel bags and backpacks. 1:34 remaining. Second half. Time to load up the RV in just about 90 seconds.
I kind of like mobile command, but that's just me.
I like that. It has a bunch of names.
We have to get it sponsored is what we have to do.
The RV, the rig, it's got a bunch of names. The Cruiser 2.0. 60 seconds to go.
And it has to be a cool sponsor. It can't be like the Lee Press on Nails RV.
Cato, while I appreciate your thoughts, I would venture to say Marty Hersom will be pleased to have it sponsored by Lee Press on Nails or anybody else. Does that hit the post?
Nice kick.
I could be critic.
Let it go, you guys, with a half minute to go. Off it goes.
I was thinking of something else.
Black Knights looking for their first goal and knocked aside with 27 to go. Playing aggressive here. Philogene out of the left, out of the right corner with 20 to play. Probably one last goalie kick. No rush. Back out to midfield it goes. As we're down to four. Down to two and one, and this one comes to an end. And the Greenwich Cardinals will take a 3-0 win on this Tuesday afternoon. Good job by the Cardinals as they improve to 6-1-2 on the year. For the Black Knights, well, they drop to 3-5-1. Greenwich was able to score in the first minute, Raquel, and I think that was, you know, it kind of set the tone.
Right, I think they really, it's a different game than when they first saw them, where they tied them. I think that Greenwich probably has had more games under their belt now, more teamwork, and they look like they really gelled together and were able to pass and have a lot of touches on the ball and get a lot of shots off.
What about for the Black Knights? What are the things?
Well, I mean, they did have a lot of shots on goal. They did a lot of opportunities, but I think their touches just weren't as clean, weren't as consistent as the Greenwich team. The Greenwich team really seems to have really fine-tuned touches on the ball and just good clears and crosses that give them open opportunities to hit the net.
So this one in the books, and the Greenwich Cardinals have beaten the Stamford Black Knights by a score of 3-0. We'll take a timeout. We'll come back out and put a wrap on it just outside of Boyle Stadium. We'll continue right after this. Final score in boys soccer, Greenwich 3, Stamford 0. You're watching the FCAC on the HAN Network.
Connecticut is coming back to hometown banking. To a partner that makes small businesses feel big. Where community comes first. Where high-tech tools go hand-in-hand with a human touch. Where you get the know-how only neighbors can deliver. Where saving time is important too. It's time to expect more. It's time to bank well. Bank smart. Bank local. Bank well.
Remind you of the last time you went into a car dealership? Experience stress-free waters at Pamby Chrysler Jeep Dodge and Ram and find out how easy buying a car really is.
When you experience a sports injury, you want to get better and fast. Coastal Ortho Express gives you direct access to orthopedic care quickly. Their physicians are fellowship trained in sports medicine at world-class universities and are also team doctors for area football teams. For specialized personal care of sports injuries, go to Coastal Ortho Express. Open Monday through Saturday in the iPark building, 761 Main Avenue in Norwalk, or coastalorthoexpress.com. Coastal Orthopedics, keeping you on the move.
Back at Stamford High School with Raquel Welsh and Chris Kalen and the rest of our crew. I'm Rob Adams. 3-0 final score as the Greenwich Cardinals beat the Stamford Black Knights. And as you know, we were talking a little earlier in the broadcast, and I was mentioning how we have viewers and listeners in places like Minnesota, and I just found out from Dallas as well, watching grandson Justin Wexler, who came in here at the very end. So kind of cool to get everybody seen here on the HAN Network. And certainly, Raquel, you know, Greenwich played well. The Black Knights have things they can fix.
Right. A lot of touches on the ball, a lot of just gelling together. I think there are some unlucky opportunities with the goals, you know, that breakaway that we talked about earlier where the goalie came out and he had the sun in his eyes and probably had a tough time trying to capture it, and there's just too many Greenwich.
Do you sense off of this game that there's that big of a separation between the two teams? Is Greenwich that much better?
They've got a lot of skills, and I think when we were looking at the roster, there are a lot of juniors on there, a lot of experienced players. I don't think it's out of the water. I mean, Stamford played them early on in the season and tied them. So I think, you know, Stamford, like the coach said at the beginning, they just really need to work together and have some more ownership as a team coming in with different skills.
I don't get a sense at this point that definitely there are the, you know, the upper echelon teams, but I don't get the sense that there, you know, is that much of a separation that one team, Cato, is so much better than anybody else in the FCAC.
I haven't seen it so far. I haven't had a chance to see a lot of games, but I've been able to read up on it. I think Greenwich, to echo what Raquel said, I think it's more of a complete team. I think everybody, they're all on the same page. I think Stamford High still has some things to work out. They played very well. They did get some opportunities. They just have to, you know, get together and convert those opportunities. If you convert the opportunities you get, you know, that's the difference. I mean, and in this game here, you're looking at the difference between a tie and a shutout.
By the way, this game has completely gone to the dogs. I just want to let you both know that is that beautiful,
he's pretty skilled.
That beautiful baby husky that we saw before is out there, kind of enjoying the atmosphere on the turf here at Stamford High School. As I mentioned, Greenwich now 6-1-2, and certainly Danbury's having a good year. Staples having a very good year at 6-1-1. Trumbull is in the mix. Those are the West Division teams that are kind of the upper group right now. On the East side is Wilton at 5-1-2 coming into today. Ward at 5-2-2. Ludlow, who we've seen and we'll see again, are 4-2-2. And then Darien kind of lingering around at 3-1-4. So, what? Again, back to my point, I don't feel like there's, where in field hockey, we know Darien is as good as it gets, and then there's everybody else below that. I don't see that here in boys soccer. Fair to say?
I'd say so.
Absolutely.
Pretty, it looks pretty even, pretty balanced as
Absolutely.
Far as a couple teams stand out with a few more wins.
Now, we remind you tomorrow, make sure you grab your daily coffee break at 11 o'clock. Kate Chaplinsky, yours truly, Donald Eng as well. Don has history. I have sports, weather, a little bit of everything else. Actually, Kate off tomorrow, so it's me running things tomorrow on your coffee break. And I'm thinking the gentleman I'm glancing at right now will be handling weather and sports tomorrow, one A.J. Simonowski. Says he's up for the task. So that's tomorrow here on the HAN Network. That goes for Thursday as well. Start time 11 o'clock on both of those shows. And then a little bit later on will be Nutmeg Sports as we move you through your Wednesday into Thursday, Yankee Fisherman and Arts and Leisure as well, to Friday coffee break. And then FCAC tailgate at 4, FCAC game day at 5, and the Stamford Black Knights go to Crotty Stadium in Danbury to take on the Danbury Hatters. Chris Irway and I will have the call for you 7 o'clock on Friday night. All right, what do you think? You going to come back?
It was great, yeah.
We'll get you more comfortable and keep you coming around?
Yeah, absolutely. It was a great time.
All right,
thanks for
sounds
having
good.
Me.
You? You're like family.
I don't think you have a choice.
I'll show up at some point.
You have great hair, so I mean, he's got to have a good talking
See?
Point.
See? The hair just, it permeates throughout the HAN Network family. Our thanks to the entire crew here on this gorgeous Tuesday afternoon. Just bottle it up. It's as nice as it gets. Bill Bloxham on a camera. Great work by him. Marty Hursom on a camera. Josh Fisher here as well. Tracy Iazzi was here earlier. A.J. Simonowski, solid as always. I'll find a way to criticize him one day. Eric Gendron directing us as well. And Cato and Raquel and I just keeping you company as we watch the Greenwich Cardinals get the win here. Nick Bartles. Alejandro McLean, 2 goals on the day, and this one in the books. The Greenwich Cardinals win by a final score of 3-0. That'll do it from Stamford High School. Final score one more time, Greenwich 3 and Stamford nothing. Our next sports broadcast comes your way, Crotty Stadium in Danbury on Friday night as the Stamford Black Knights take on the Danbury Hatters. Game time at 7 o'clock, pregame activities at 4. We remind you, a big old thanks to Walter Stewart's Market, Carl Chevrolet, Pamby Motors, Bankwell, and Coastal Orthopedics. They bring you the FCAC on the HAN Network. For all of us here at Stamford High School on a beautiful Tuesday afternoon, enjoy your evening. We'll talk to you tomorrow for coffee break. For my broadcast colleagues, Chris Callen, Raquel Welsh, I'm Rob Adams. Enjoy your evening. See you tomorrow. Coffee break at 11. Good night from Stamford.
Preceding has been a presentation of the HAN Network, the leader for local news, sports, and entertainment in Fairfield and Westchester counties.